So, you got the feel of the bike now?
Yeah.
You know where you're going?
Vaguely. Vaguely.
The bell works.
Yeah,
hi everyone. I'm sure most of you'll know by now I've been trying to motivate T to pull out on her bike and do the blue route on Cannock Chase. And you won't be surprised to know that as of yet she's not motivated to do it. However, the daughter-in-law Lisa piped up the other day that, oh, I'll do it, it's easy on an e-bike. And T was very quick to say, well, you can borrow mine then. So this video was filmed about a week or so ago when I took Lisa out for her first time riding a blue route on Cannock Chase. We picked the video up at the start. We'd just done a slow loop around to familiarise her with the Perry's Trail and get a general feel for the bike and the trail. And this is on the second lap round. And she's still struggling a bit with the e-bike. I had to tell her not to keep standing up to pedal uphill. This section is the fun one with the jumps on. So I went ahead on here and had a bit of a blast through myself and then set myself up ready to film her coming down the trail. So it's the first time she's ever ridden anything other than sort of fire roads. So I think she did quite well on the whole, but I don't think it was quite as easy as she thought it was. Here she comes now, doing reasonably well down these. Certainly, certainly it's only a second time down. That's not bad going. And we sort of took it in turns, leapfrogging down the sections. I do like this one, it does flow really well. It's pretty much, I think, one of my favourite sections of the new blue route. And I keep saying to T that you've got to get used to riding these berms and following the clean line on them, which Lisa wasn't too bad at. She's not going to break any land speed records, but at least she's staying on the black stuff, which is the important bit. She's waiting for me there for me to come back past her after I'd filmed. And then we follow this section through until we come out at the bottom of Cardiac Hill, which she was quite adamant she didn't want to ride up Cardiac Hill, although I did get her up there later on. So Perry's Trail is an excellent trail for beginners. It's superb for building skills. There's plenty of opportunities to dip out and do the odd red stage here and there, and there's quite a difficult red section up this climb, up the middle there. It's not something I enjoy doing. Straight up the staircase sort of thing. Lisa was doing quite well at this stage. I sort of paused at the top of this climb and she was right behind me, which was not that I was going that fast, but I then tried to blat ahead down here, thinking I'll go ahead and I'll film her coming towards me. However, she wasn't that far behind me, so I didn't actually get to film her coming down this bit. So she'd obviously get in the hang of it, and not going quite as quickly as I am, but she certainly wasn't hanging around on here, and certainly seemed to be enjoying herself, which is the main thing, of course. So we carried on around here and then across into the next section. I mean, the whole Perry's blue route is only 2.7 miles long, so it is not at all difficult. If you're going at a fair pace, you can do it in about 15 minutes, and I think it took us about 3/4 of an hour in total to go round, and we were stopping and chatting after each section, and you know, I was going ahead to film bits, or try to, when I could get ahead of Lisa. And on the whole, it was good fun. Certainly built a lot of confidence up for going through the single track stuff. And at the end of it, when we'd finished doing the whole route, she did actually opt to come and have a go at some of the follow the dog sections on the red, and we did about 2/3 of that. So it's certainly built a bit of confidence. And okay. One thing I think she did realise was it isn't quite as easy as you think it's going to be riding an e-bike. You still have to put a fair bit of effort in as well, but it does just give you that bit of help on the climbs, which is great fun. I could ride around here all day. Love these nice flowing bends on here. Absolutely excellent. So there you go, folks. If you're thinking of taking somebody out who's never been on a single track before, I can highly recommend Perry's Trail. It's certainly good fun. It's not particularly difficult, and it will inspire a bit of confidence and give them the opportunity to improve their skills a bit. There's some nice little slightly techie features, like that staircase I've just gone down there, which is all very rollable, but it gives you that bit of confidence that you can try something a little bit harder, and I think that's obviously what it's designed to do. So if you've enjoyed this video, please give, think about bopping the like button. I'd appreciate that, it all helps. And if you'd like to see more content like this, then feel free to subscribe. So here we go, just the last few bends now on Perry's Trail before we come out at the end, and then we moved off onto the red. So thanks for watching, folks, really appreciate it, and I'll see you on the next video.